How to turn your Notion dashboard from looking like this into something that looks like this. This video will show you how to make your Notion even more aesthetic. Let's get started. Before we start, the dark mode setting can be found under the notifications and settings tab. Here we have a very basic Notion dashboard with a few pre-made databases. The very first thing we're going to do is add a Notion icon and an animated cover that's congruent with the theme of our dashboard. So let's click on the icon, and under the icons tab, you have the option to manually choose the color of your icon, or you can pre-select the color. Let's go ahead and choose our icon and then move on to the Notion cover. When you click on add cover, you can select a cover from Notion's gallery, upload your own, add a link, or choose a cover from the stock free photo website Unsplash. You can quickly create clean looking Notion covers with CoverCons and Notion Cover Generator, or you can create your own from scratch using Canva. For this dashboard, however, we're going to use an animated cover. You can find tons of GIFs on Giphy.com or by searching Animated Pixel City on Pinterest. In the description, I'll leave a link to my animated Notion cover pinboard, which is where I got the cover for this dashboard from. Now that we got our icon and cover, let's add some widgets and then move on to the databases. There are a bunch of widget websites you can use, and I'll leave links in the description for each of them. But for this dashboard, we'll only be using a clock and button widget from Indify.co. Each widget has a bunch of customization options. For the clock widget, we're going to use the analog smooth option, use the 24-hour clock, turn off the seconds text, and we're going to turn on dark mode. Then simply copy the link and paste it into Notion as an embed and align it to the left. Now for the button widget. The first thing I'm going to do is change the button widget to dark mode, and then under the button section I'm going to add a new button for YouTube. When you click on the icon and go to the tab on the right, you'll have the option to choose logos from different social media platforms. I'm going to select the YouTube logo and then also paste in my YouTube channel link under the URL section. For the color, I'm going to select green, and then under the advanced colors, I'm going to change the background color to the same as Notion and change the text color to white for a nice looking green outline. And then lastly, I'm going to make the button corners round. If you want to add more than one button, simply copy the other buttons and change the content inside. When you're done, copy the link and paste it into Notion as an embed and align it to the left. Now it's time to make some changes to the databases. The very first thing would have to be to hide the database titles. We're also going to replace the names for database views with a spacebar to give a more minimalist look. Of course, if you're using specific views for specific reasons, then it's better to have names on the database views. However, I would suggest making them all lowercase letters. Next is the database outline. For this, we're going to use a callout box set to the default color and drag and drop our database inside. In the callout box, we can insert a name for our database, make it bold and also underline it, and select our theme color. And because it's a callout box, we also have the option to add an icon. If you want to go a step further, then you can add the database name in all caps with a space in between each letter for a more minimalist look. Because our database are now inside of callout boxes, it also makes it a lot easier to drag them around and create multi-column layouts with. To create the multi-column layout, all you have to do is just drag the block next to another one until you see the blue vertical line, and then resize the layout by dragging the gray bar in between the two columns. Once you've created your multi-column layout, just go ahead and drag and drop all the other blocks underneath the column. For this dashboard, I'm going to have all the databases on the right and the widgets, notes section, and the other pages on the left with the calendar at the bottom. Now let's make some changes inside the databases, starting with the template buttons. For the projects database, I'm going to create a template button for each type of project that recurs on a regular basis and add a relevant icon for each of them. I'm also going to copy the link for the task database and paste it inside of the template button and filter the task database to this current template button. So each time you click on this template button, it will add an icon as well as a self-referencing database showing all the tasks related to this current project. I'm also going to add template buttons for the task database so that I can load the icons quicker. And if you have an icon that you use for majority of the tasks, then you can set that template button as default, meaning every time you add a new task, the icon will automatically be applied. Next is the relation property. When you click inside the relation property, you are able to show the properties of the related database and organize them as you wish. If you click on the property menu, you are able to display the relation property as its own section at the bottom, or you can display it in a minimal view, which works similar to how backlinks are displayed. Another amazing feature is being able to group database entries according to relations. Here we have a list view of our tasks, and each task is related to a project. Inside the database settings under grouping, you can group the list view database according to the project relation. This allows you to open and collapse database groups, making everything look a lot cleaner. When dealing with board views, under the layout tab you have the option to turn on the colored board view toggle, making the whole column the same color rather than just the title. And the last aesthetic tip is that you can remove the vertical lines for a normal table database to get a more simplistic look. So now you know how to make your Notion more aesthetic, but do you know everything you need to know about Notion? If you want to become a Notion Pro in less than 20 minutes, then check out my previous Notion tutorial. And feel free to grab the Notion dashboard used in this video through the first link in the description. Make sure to give this video a like and subscribe for more Notion content. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.